Good morning, everybody. How are you? Good. Well, it is wonderful to be here. And we have a lot in store for you really over the next day and a half, couple of days, a lot of educational things and what we're doing at Sabre, but also just some fun activities to really get to know each other a little bit better and bond and what's taking place. I want to share a little bit before I get into my presentation, just of my background. And the reason I'm doing that, it helps you understand how Sabre is thinking about the future. Bringing people together from different sectors of the travel industry on how do we create products and services that are going to pole vault us into the next number of years. My background is actually in the airline business. I spent the vast majority of my career in the planning, revenue management, chief commercial officer at Air Canada. I was the CEO of an airline called Frontier, low-cost carrier in the US. And in doing that, in joining the organization a year ago, I bring a lens that allows me to blend with all of my colleagues and teammates at Sabre about how do we look at the future and what's taking place. Because it is changing. Market demands are changing. Technology is driving what people want, and they want it now. So what I'm going to talk about, really, is walking through the vision that we have at Sabre and what product is being developed. And I'm going to take it at a high level, and then I'm going to drive it down relative to passing it off to Wade Jones, who's our Senior Vice President of Strategy and Marketing. And you're going to begin to see these things that we are developing and taking to market, but also understanding what's behind that thought process. Years of industry experience and the number of things that we do focused on how do we all become more successful going forward. Sound good? Okay, good. So, let me tell you about the story. The story is about suppliers. The story is about agencies, many of you in this room. And the story is about travelers. Probably the most important thing we always have to focus on, the customers that we are serving at the end of the day. This is the world that we live in. This is the world that we're focused on how do we create better things. As Rashaan was talking earlier, it doesn't matter if it's business or family. We travel to experience, to do different things around the world. We do that. We as a collective industry do that. This is our world. So at Sabre, if you look at it, we look at it from the perspective of we have all these suppliers on the left-hand side that we bring in, over 425 airlines around the world, 750 hotels around the world, a plethora of content that we can actually bring in. And in doing that, it is made up of the suppliers, providing to agencies, driving to the travelers. So the reason we're going to walk through this, and it really builds upon our strategy and what's taking place, is how are we thinking of it through these lenses and understanding the dynamics that are taking place and the technology and where it'll drive. So for us, you're going to hear us talk a lot about platforms. And the foundation of our strategy is really based on business intelligence and optimization. It's one thing that Rashaan was talking about. If you look at the wealth of information that we have, we are a lead indicator of the economy. I know what's being shopped. I know what's being booked. I know if it's leisure. I know if it's business. I know it by region. How do we take information like that and provide it to you to better understand how you can run your business? How do we take other data and analytics to allow you to understand how you can serve customers even better? Personalization and merchandising. This is one thing we are all talking about. We're all under pressure to drive more revenue. And part of that is personalization and merchandising. How are we selling the right product to the right person at the right time? Suppliers are really trying to do that. We see that specifically on the airline side of the equation. How am I selling ancillary fares? How am I selling branded fares? What are the ways that I can lock people in? At Air Canada, we experimented something with which was called subscription travel. You can actually buy and fly unlimited. Didn't work so well. But it's how do people think about things going forward? And then automation and efficiency. For everything to be successful, for you to be successful, is how are we driving automation and efficiency into your workflows. Because as it becomes more complex relative to what you're trying to sell, how do we make sure that you're not losing productivity? Because it is a productivity game. How are we actually putting tools in front that are intuitive to help understand how you can actually do better for your customers? So with that, what I'm going to do is just walk through some of the trends that are taking place in each of these that have actually allowed us to inform ourselves on our strategy and what's taking place. So let me start really with the airlines and what's going on and the way that we're looking at the airline world. So I mentioned Air Canada in my time there. So this was back in 2005. And at that time, we were launching the branded fares and the ancillary revenues 10 years ago. And it's really beginning to ramp up a little bit more now. And the reason I bring this up is because there was a business need for Air Canada to do that because it had a competitor in the marketplace, a low-cost competitor that was very good called WestJet. Lower cost structure. Air Canada was a higher cost structure airline and couldn't compete effectively. So we had to create products and services that allowed us to sell that same type of product, which drove, at that time, a lot of conflict relative to the GDS. How do you actually help us sell the products and services the way that we want? Today, that's transforming. And what you're seeing in products and capabilities is how we're delivering those things that are taking place. Because suppliers are looking at how they continue to drive their revenue going forward. If we look at some of the trends, global capacity is growing about 3.5%, greater than GDP. If you look at this region, the APAC region, by far the fastest growing region in the world. You're going to hear more of me talk about what we're doing in the region and why we're so focused because of the growth that is taking place here. But with that, low-cost carriers as well as full-service carriers, the business models are different. So how do we make sure that the technology is there? Low-cost carriers make up 25% of global seats today. That's up 5 points in the last 5 years. The other stunning number is the ancillary revenues, and this is just ancillary revenues. Ancillary revenues are $60 billion worldwide. That's up from $30 billion 5 years ago. By 2020, it's estimated that ancillary revenues will be over $100 billion. But today, 90% of ancillary revenues are actually sold through direct distribution. When you look at what's taking place relative to suppliers, their focus to drive more revenue, there is the need to sell ancillary products, branded fares better through the GDS network. That by which you are very focused on making sure that we develop what needs to be done. The other thing that's taking place that I will share with you is there's a commercial model that also has to work with that. And we're spending a lot of time with suppliers on if you are going to sell those products and services, how are you actually compensated for it at the end of the day? Because if you don't solve that problem, it's not going to happen. This is not easy. But I'm sharing this with you because it's a way we're thinking about the world. It's the way that we're thinking about how the world is going to transform and how do we create a larger revenue pie that we can all share in. The next one is really on the hotel side of the equation. We don't talk much about it. The vast majority of our revenue from Sabre transactions comes from the airline side. But there's a lot of things that are continuing to play out that we can't forget about as it relates to the opportunity. Bookings continue to grow substantially, as you can see here over the last 5 years. We know that if you get a hotel, the likelihood of getting an attachment rate of ground transportation is a lot higher. And the margins are a lot higher. So how are we looking at making sure that capability, content, is also taking place on the non-air side of the equation? And you'll see the team talk about many of the things that are going on there. Let's transition to the agency side of the equation. And I find this very dynamic in what we're seeing right now. And we were with a group yesterday just talking about some of the things that are going on. But I think it's important as you begin to break down what is happening. And I do want to sort of do a bifurcation. And that bifurcation is really what we're seeing with online travel agencies, so the online side of the equation, versus the offline, the brick and mortar side. What is being requested is very different. There's a lot of similarities, but there are things that are very different in what's being asked of. And as we look at platform and platform technology, we have to make sure that we are filling the needs of all agencies that are out there. And how is that being done relative to the technology platform? As you can see, bookings continue to grow over the last 5 years, 10% really on a global basis. The thing that we're facing, this is what I mentioned earlier, is the increased selling of the ancillary products, the merchandising side of the equation. The ability to shift that into the GDS and our ability to help you sell that will be substantial for everybody to be successful. And then the platform. And the best way of thinking about the platform, and this is how I articulate it, if we are doing the right job, we are creating relationships, enhancing those relationships with suppliers and pulling in that content that they want to sell. And in doing that, how do we serve it up to the agency community to be able to distinguish their products and services from the way that they want to serve this to customers? And what you're going to see is essentially with Sabre Red Workspace, the new Sabre Red Workspace, we're essentially have built that based off of APIs. So when that's taking place, if you're an online travel agency, if you're a corporate booking tool, if you're a mobile, emerging technology going forward, it's how do you want to use the content capabilities and functionality that we're presenting? Because there becomes a level of how you want to differentiate yourself in the marketplace. So this is the way that we really look at the world from an agency side. The last, the traveler. Really, who we are in business to serve at the end of the day. There's many trends that are taking place out there, but the one that I'm going to spend just a few minutes talking about is mobile and what's happening. And we look at this relative to how do they just manage the journey? How are things being booked? You know, Rashawn was talking about booking through mobile, and what we're seeing is a lot of people are shopping. True booking from a mobile perspective hasn't truly gotten there. We're finding that a lot of people still go to the desktop from an online perspective, but that will continue to change. The other part of it is really trip management. Actually having everything within an app or profile capability of not only the air, but the hotel, the ground transportation, and what other activities can be brought forward. So when you look at it, and let me take you back relative to the ability of bringing in content, how can we continue to bring in an enormous amount of content that can be served up? And mobility is that, the way of looking at it. The other portion that we focus on is how the world is actually changing. And it is the millennial generation relative to how they shop, how they look. How do we make sure that technology enables you to be able to serve the new customer that is continuing to grow throughout the marketplace? I'm going to shift gears a little bit. And I want to talk about our commitment to the region and what's taking place. So, as everybody knows, the Abacus acquisition took place a little over a year ago. Sabre has 10,000 employees worldwide. Today, we have 2,000 employees within this region. In Bangalore, we have over 1,000 programmers. In Singapore, it's our regional headquarter. Our focus is how do we continue to develop in the marketplace. We really have four global centers that are out there. Singapore is the APAC, Montevideo, Latin America, Dallas, North America, and then London is EMEA. When we look at the world, there are two areas that we are extremely focused on as it relates to growth, EMEA and APAC. And it makes sense relative to the growth when you go back to what I was talking about on how airlines are growing, what's taking place, the complexity in what's going on. So when we look at it, we have presence from a global perspective and what's going on in the marketplace. Let me walk you through really the penetration that we have. So before we acquired Abacus, this was really Abacus market share in the marketplace, 37.5%. Today, 1 year later, we're sitting at 40.5%. If we look into the future, based on organic growth, new contracts, we believe we'll be at 46% of the market share by 2018. The commitment that we have is how do we continue to take it to the next level? How do we look at it relative to data centers? Continuing to grow our employee base. It's the commitment that we have, and it's making sure that you have the products and services to be successful. So with that, we believe that we're very well positioned for the complexity on a global basis. This is a complex industry. You know, I've often talked to people and they ask about the industry and they just say, why don't you change this? Why don't you do this? It's not that easy. It is very, very complex. We have deep relationships on the supplier side, on the agency side. We're spending a lot of time understanding the consumer. We're really looking at our technology and how does our technology have to transform to be able to enable. How are we helping educate? You know, part of a good business and part of a good partner is how do we actually lead change? It's not always about listening to what people want. It's actually stepping up and saying, we're going to lead change. Sabre sits in a wonderful position. I haven't talked about the other parts of the business. If you look at Sabre, it's really three business components. There's travel network. There's our airline solutions business, as well as our hospitality business. We are at the heart of airlines. We are at the heart of hotels. A lot of the things we're talking about wanting to sell from a merchandising, retailing perspective, that has to be operationalized. You actually have to fulfill that commitment to the customer at the end of the day. There's not many companies in the world that can do that. There's not many people or many companies. They're investing hundreds of millions of dollars in new products each year. How are we enhancing what's taking place? How are we partnering? And that's what it's about. It's about sitting with partners and talking about the future. It's actually about arguing about the future, debating the future, understanding what's taking place. But things are changing, and they're changing at a rapid pace. And our ability to continue to look and enable suppliers to sell what they're trying to do to be successful in what's taking place and being that platform in between, that technology provider to you to sell those products and services, to be able to transform the commercial model by which everybody wins is our focus. So you have our commitment, and again, what you're going to see really throughout the presentations over the next couple of days is what that means and how we're bringing that to life. And that's what's fun about this, is it's alive. These products are out there, we're rolling them out, and they will be very transformational in how we can all be successful going forward. So with that, I again want to just thank you for being here. It's a commitment, as I always tell people when we attend and pull ourselves out of the workplace, because there's so many things that are going on, but I really do appreciate you taking the time to understand what we are doing at Sabre, and specifically what we are trying to do to make our partnership stronger and make you more successful. So thank you very much.